Hello everyone, I am CA Sanjana Mishra, currently working as the lead functional consultant at BISP Solutions, having 7 years of experience as Oracle EPM consultant across different business segments. BISP Solutions is a tech company providing technological solutions worldwide. So we as your tech partners have a far-flung proficiency in end-to-end implementation and support in Oracle EPM solution stack. It includes SBase, planning budgeting, financial consolidation cloud, and accounts reconciliations cloud. We have served more than 35 countries across the globe with more than 50 projects delivered to happy customers. Most of the companies put their hard efforts in manually reconciling the accounting books, and this process is performed monthly in almost all of the companies. Apart from the efforts put in by the human capital, issues like incomplete information, limited visibility, security issues are also a major concern in manually performing the reconciliations process. Hence, applications of Oracle, that is account reconciliation cloud service, comes to the rescue of the companies by automating the whole reconciliation process by effectively managing and comprehensively addressing the security and risk issues. For today's session, we'll be taking up intercompany transaction matching. With the help of transaction matching, companies can automate the preparations of high-volume, labor-intensive reconciliations and seamlessly integrate those results into the tracking features within reconciliations compliance. This powerful new module will save the companies additional time on performing on the performance of reconciliations while improving the quality and reducing the risk. So let us just get an overlook of what is actually intercompany account reconciliations. Intercompany accounts reconciliations is basically when two branches of the same company or two subsidiaries or a parent or a subsidiary get into a transaction of buying or selling of a product or a fixed asset or maybe just transacting of a liability or something like that. When any transactions happen between the two entities of the same parent or of a single company, two branches of the single company, and hence that is the reason the accounts receivables and accounts payable needs to be reconciled. One entity would be providing the product, the other entity would be paying for it. And hence, one company would become an accounts receivable in the book, and the other company would become a part of the accounts payable. And hence, accounts receivables and accounts payable of both the entities shall be reconciled. So I should just look at the amount, the prices, profit element, and there are so many things that could be just looked upon with the help of reconciliation. So today we'll be reconciling intercompany accounts of two entities, that is two branches of the same entity. And the reconciliation account ID that we'll be using is 303-INCO. So this is just a reconciliation account ID that I have already created under the Oracle ARCS app. Let us just get down to our Oracle ARCS application. So as you can see, this is the Oracle ARCS application. Let us just start with getting an insight about on what is the profile actually contains. What are the important elements of my profile? So this is the profile that I have created, and the two entities that I would like to perform a reconciliation or a transaction matching is an entity 96 and entity 87. So these are two entities of my company. And the process I'll be using is, of course, balance sheet process. The risk rating in my company is medium. You can have your own kind of risk rating. Account type is, of course, intercompany receivable. And the format that I've used is transaction matching intercompany. So the method has already is automatically taken up from the format only. This is the main part of my whole profile where I have had a workflow and an instruction has been provided to the preparer, which is a formal instruction. And these are my workflows. The currency that I'll be using is a functional currency because I am a single country entity, that is domestic company. I am not an MNC and hence I do not have a different entered function and reporting currency. Though if you are a multinational company, you can have your own entered function and reporting currency differently. So this is where I am transact. These are the main parts of my profile. Now coming down to my format that I have used is transaction matching intercompany. So this is my transaction matching intercompany format that I have used for the purpose of creating my profile of intercompany accounts receivables transaction matching. So as you can see, the source system is intercompany AR and intercompany AP, that is the accounts receivables for intercompany and accounts payable for the intercompany. Then I have got the adjustment to source system, adjustment to subsystem tabs and everything. And here, as you can see, the method that I have used is balance comparison with transaction matching. So this is my profile. And one more thing, that the match type that I have used is intercompany. So this is different. This is the different element in my transaction matching module, apart from my reconciliations compliance module. So ARCS comes with dual module feature where I can also just match and reconcile on the balance part, and also I can reconcile each and every transaction along with my balance, so that I'll get a dual check on accuracy of matching the transaction as an invoice ID, dates and everything, and also the balance shall be matched. So here the match type that I have used is intercompany. Match types, if you say, if I just put it like that, in reconciliations compliance, you create a profile on the base of a format. But in transaction matching, there is one more element added to my profile creation and reconciliation is, I create a profile on the basis of my format, and the format is actually created on the basis of my match type. So from here, I'll be able to see what is the match type that I have used. I have used the intercompany match type. It has got actually 5 tabs. I'll just go on a high level overview on all those tabs. This is the basic properties, as in the name, the ID, description and everything. Then is the data sources. So data sources, actually, if you take it in a very simple language, data sources are basically, if I open my accounts payable book, what are the columns and what are the columns that I will be looking into my accounts payable or an accounts receivable book. Like if I open my accounts payable book, it is going to have a date, invoice column, an AP amount column, inverse amount column, currency column, document column. So these are actually those attributes similar to what I maintain in my Excel sheet. If I open an Excel sheet of my company of accounts payable, it is going to have these 9-10 columns. So I have just put it out here so that it is, because on those basis only, any one of those source attributes basis, you are going to match the transactions. Because if you need to match a transaction, you'll have to take a base. We'll look into it in the third tab. So this is my accounts payable attributes and everything, and this is my accounts receivables attributes. So of course, there is no way where both the number of attributes under my accounts payable and receivable will be same. The reason being, it is an intercompany, both the branches can have their own way of maintaining the books. Of course, there'll be a policy for a standardized doings, but of course the date of pay, let's say the date of payment for accounts payable will be an additional column. In accounts receivable, it might have a different date, it might have a different column, the location, time, or it can have different ways of maintaining things. So the number of attribute columns, as in the number of columns, may not be same or can be same. Now the third type is my transaction types, as in what kind of transactions type I'll be matching. Like this is the basic transaction type adjustment. This is the adjustment, as in if my matches are both the amounts, both the invoices or something like that is not matching, then what are the headings under which I am going to create the match? Let's say there is accounts payable book has $100 and accounts receivables book shows $105. So I can have a discrepancy, a difference of maybe a coding error, of maybe an invoice difference, maybe a currency exchange difference or something like that. So I'm just putting a main heading, as in under which heading I'm going to put the adjustment. If I get any adjustment, if I get any discrepancy, and I want to adjust that discrepancy under which heading, under which main head am I going to explain that adjustment. So here I've just created like coding error, invoice dispute, difference of invoices, in invoicing number, currency exchange or currency differences, and any other, if any other adjustment type if I want to. So I've just created other, and if the discrepancy does not fall under the above three categories, it is going to fall under my other category. The fifth is the match process. Now, match process is very important because under match process, I'm going to define the base for my match. On which basis, on which account, on which amount, on which number am I going to match the transactions of my two books? Like here, the default attribute mapping, as in the default attribute mapping, with the way I'm going to match is my amount and my date. So when I'm going to match the transactions of both the books, I'm going the matches shall be created on the basis of the amount and on the basis of the date. Under AR, the attribute name is amount. Under AP, that is the accounts payable, it is the inverse amount. And if also, if I think any other amount is included, any other like invoice number or something, if I want, I can add an invoice number also. So it totally depends on the company and the organization. And this is my journal entry attribute, like the journal, if my adjustments, if I'm going to have an adjustment, this is my way of adjusting the amounts, as in the ledger ID, date, journal source, currency code, the entity reconciliation ID, category, adjusting debit amount or a credit amount. So it is just for the adjustments. You can have attributes depending on your organization. This is just for the adjustment journal entry. Let's say if it is $100 and $200, there's a difference of $100. So how am I going to adjust that $100? Though I have identified it that it was a invoice defect where a wrong invoice was identified, but I would have to account for $100 also, the difference. So this is how I'm going to just map the difference of the adjustment. So this was my match type. Let us just go directly to our profile. This is the profile. Since I was working on it, so I have already created the reconciliations. Before going to my profile ID, I would just... Now, match types do not have a set way of, like, reconciliation. You need to open the period, then reconciliation, a profile, create reconciliation, and so. Here, there are three steps. You can... you have to open the period first, as... I'll be performing the reconciliation for the period of April 2019. So after opening the period, I am just going to create the reconciliation for my profile. Yes, so this is the profile for which I would like to create a reconciliation. Now, of course, balance mapping, uploading the balance, and all of that is will be done. So it totally depends. You want to create a reconciliation before or upload the balance. But since we are working all here, so I just jumped onto this profiles tab. As I had already informed you, I was already working, so it is already running this profile. Had it not been running, it would have shown successfully copied as number one and unsuccessfully copied the number as zero. Yes, so now coming to my Excel sheet that I will be using. As you can see here, this is my accounts payable sheet, formatted sheet that I'll be using for the purpose of uploading the transactions. It contains the reconciliation ID, date, invoice, inverse amount, and payment date. And this is my accounts receivables Excel sheet that I'll be using to upload the balance of my accounts receivables book, which contains the columns of reconciliation ID, date, invoice, and amount. Moving back to our application, from here, under match type, that is transaction matching, the loading of the balance, usually in reconciliation compliance, the balance is loaded from the period tab only. But in transaction matching, I jump to my jobs card. Sorry, jobs tab. And from here, actions, import transaction. Select the match type. I am using the intercompany match type that we have just seen. Now, this is dependent on the administrator whether they want to run the auto match or not. Auto match means when I am uploading the sheets, that is my balances for both the system, it is going to run an auto match there and then. So I'll not have to match each and every transaction one by one. I prefer using it as yes, so it is easier for me to just get an insight of what is the difference and everything. Now, as you can see, the date format in my sheet was DDMMYY. I have selected it. In your sheet, you can have a different date format and select it from here. So, accounts payable is my this sheet that we have just seen. And accounts receivable is my subsystem sheet that I'll be using, which I have done. I'm just going to submit it. And I can just check my progress from here. It is here showing pending. I'm going to refresh it until it is showing an error or succeeded. So as you can see, my results shows that I have successfully copied my uploaded the balance on my profile. So going to the home button, I'll just go to my matching section. So here is my reconciliation ID. Now, as you can see, I had already run the auto match and hence it is showing me the result. Had I not run an auto match from there, I also have an option of running the auto match from here, as you can see, run auto match. Had I not clicked it there, I would have run an auto match from here also. Now, as you can see, these are the these are the results that are showing. This is just an overview. All suggested matches are there where with I have certain matches, that one match that contains an adjustment. We look into it from here. There are no unmatched transaction. The reason being, it was suggested match. There are different. There is a confirmed match and there is a suggested match. So it provides me with a suggested match also. As in, these are the adjustments that can be done, and you can match the transaction of both the files. So this is my transaction ID, where the date here is 8th of April 2019. The invoice is same. The amount here in my accounts receivable is showing 5490, and my accounts payable book is showing for that particular invoice on that date is showing a amount of 5487. So there is a variance of 2.77. So here I can choose whether I need to provide an adjustment to receivables book or a payables book. I am choosing to provide a adjustment to accounts receivables book. I can, so we have seen the adjustments type. So I would put it under other, ID name, description, rounding off is my description, ledger ID, depending on your organization's ID transactions. And entity I can select is 86. And I will just confirm it. So now there are all matches, no suggested matches. As in, I've confirmed the adjustment that was there. There are no unmatched transaction over here. And you can see there is no unmatched transaction. Before, it was showing an unmatched transaction of 1, which we have adjusted of 2.77. That was a rounding off error. Oh, sorry, rounding off adjustment. So less matched in transit is showing this amount. No difference is showing. No unmatched transaction I can see. Matches, there were 4 matches that were exact match and 1 adjustment that we have just given an effect to. And this is how I've just managed the transaction of both the books, which could have taken me quite a lot of time if I would have actually done it manually. And in my manual process, it would also include certain errors, because these such small amount error, though it was just $2.77, but still it is an amount which it already showed. Had I been performing it manually, I would have just skipped it, thinking it is not an important, it is not that much material, which it was, of course, but I have looked it upon that small difference also, and I have already provided a description and adjustment to that amount, so that there are no unmatched transactions as in. So this is how simply I can just match my transactions of two books under intercompany using the Oracle ARCS Cloud. And in case of any doubts of this particular profile or regarding ARCS or any Oracle EPM stack, you can of course contact us at www.bispsolutions.com, where we would be more than happy to help you. Thank you so much. Have a good day.